I even thinking? Really, I was thinking we're not going to get married, so whatever goes.
I don't care. Anyway, this random guy that I just steal some money
we're
from.
We're not married. Obviously, we're not married.
He lost all our savings.
God, yeah, so but that was actually a short time. Yeah, 3 months, but... Ciao ragazzi and welcome back to Lampis. So we are here today to discuss something about really serious about our money and what happened to us few months ago when there was the stock market crash. I actually was losing a lot of our net worth and Lampi here, she was not happy.
Yes, I wanted to know from you, the question of the day is really, what is the biggest financial loss that your partner has caused in your relationship?
For you, for example, you try on an investment point, you trust me completely because you don't have the knowledge to take the decision on your own.
Completely no, because I have to still check and check. It's a level of a challenge. If I have to think of quarantine time and all our saving, I would say most, maybe over 80% of our savings at the moment, they are all in stock investing. Now, the manager, the financial manager here was there, and I was like, quarantine time, I was also home, so I had so much time to check and worry. so much time to check on what he's up to, and so all the graphs were down, and there I was just like, oh my goodness, we have lost it all. All our savings are gone, and everything we've been working for the past, all the time we've been together, every cent we've put together, now that is investing, is gone. And I was asking all the question. I was worried, you know, because I was sitting at, maybe it's time to sell and
you
we just take the loss. That you
reading. There was no so much money gone. We were down substantially on our investment. That is true, but the money was still there. The fact is, if you sell the money when you are losing it, then the money becomes really like you are losing the money because you sell the stocks and there's no possibility to you to work up the value that has fallen. But that was not the case. Thank goodness, we purchased shares of companies that are trustworthy and they were doing really good and they had a good balance sheet. So it doesn't matter the market go down. If you are convinced about the investment that you have made, you should be stuck. And to be honest, that's what I did during the crisis. We bought some fewer stocks. And that's something that it's good for you because that is actually the best moment to buy stock. When the stocks goes down, it's like there are discounts, you know, it's discount season and you go to the shop and you buy your favorite coat for half of the price of, you know, 40% off. That is like a Christmas for me.
I got what you're saying, and it's actually very nice to think of it that way. Maybe for the first time you explained it in a simpler term that I super understood what it means. Because if you say, it's like when I go to H&M or Zara, every time when there's 40% discount and I want to take everything. And in those moments, it's not the time where I think of I should take things back to the shop because it's also when the things are super cheap, it's very nice. But I think, I don't know, it's your saving. You have worked so hard for them for the past five, I don't know how many years. So whether you lose, I think for me, panic comes always. Even if you lose 5%, I'm already like, oh, we could have still have what? 100% and not 95% because the 5% is gone.
Yeah,
so
but that was actually a short time because thank goodness the market went
three
back
months.
Up. Yeah, 3 months, but... You know, now actually we are earning a substantial amount of money from our investment, so we are happy. And that is what it is count. Now we need to balance it out. Probably we need to disinvest some of our portfolio and be a little bit more cash.
Yes, now we are doing and we are happy. And I think that's the most amazing part of marriage, when things are going very well. But today is going to be a hot mess with this video because the lighting is not as we can't control it, the weather is changing, then there's also the board and stuff, everybody putting
it's not up to you.
Yeah, but I don't know, I want to give out the best content
and
the best quietest environment ever.
I think there is a boat conference,
no, like,
maybe the
no,
politics,
yeah. politics is the thing. I want to say a demonstration.
Demonstration.
No, I think it's just the competition with the, I don't know what is it called, this, that, the, with the guys that we always see in the morning, two, you know, in a canoe, drink like this. Anyways, no.
Okay, we need to go close the windows because otherwise...
The windows are already closed.
Okay.
No, the one behind you is not closed, so investments.
Yeah, we did actually, the first investment we did at all was in Namibia.
Had I lost that? I mean, it was amazing and it did make us some profit. As beginners was amazing. Had I lost that, how would I have reacted to it?
We would move forward because I think the law would have prevailed, but I wouldn't have trusted you with my money anymore.
Ooh, you see?
Yeah, no.
And that was not going to be in control. If the market didn't go well, I could not control that. It has nothing to do with my trust. Those are the problems.
Mm-hmm.
So you're saying, had that investment, and that was our first thing together,
mm-hmm.
and it was my, what was I even thinking? Okay, I was thinking we're not going to get married, so whatever goes.
I don't care. Anyway, this random guy that I just steal some money
we're
from.
Not married. Obviously, we're not married. I was not thinking so much about how this could be complicated for our marriage or so. I was like, okay, whatever it goes. But first, let's start here. I'm learning
mm-hmm.
something, and maybe hopefully he's also learning something,
mm-hmm.
and we see how it goes. But like you really say, had that gone bad,
that would
it would
have
changed
it.
Your perception on me and managing our finances or when it comes to financial decision in our relationship. And that is, that is tricky. So maybe I would say to get that trust from your partner,
mm-hmm.
start with something small
mm-hmm.
that has low risk and just show that I've been, even if you're saving it, I've been keeping it here. It
mm-hmm.
has been there for, I don't know, in our saving account for 12 months and I got a 1%. But you see, honey, the money has been there. You can trust me with it and then move forward and do risky stuff.
Mm-hmm. That is so.
We'll say that. Yeah, but I feel the same. I think that trust of who is investing money where or purchasing what and stuff has to be gained first,
mm-hmm.
depending on your
Absolutely.
First years of the relationship, what decisions are you making?
Mm-hmm.
And when you gain that, I think it's easier to just say, honey, give me all your money. If you're allowed. If you're not allowed, start with your own.
Mm-hmm.
That's still, whether it's a combined account or a separate account, it's your money. So if you lose it, you're still going to be in trouble.
Absolutely.
So, it's very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I was always and has always been there for save every single coin where it's possible. Then you came in and you're more like, saving is good, Lempi, but we need to do more, invest.
I mean, you need to put these savings to use. And that doesn't mean that you have to spend them, but you need to make this money, make more money for yourself. You need to make your money, your saving, work for yourself and increase your network. That is a process that takes time. It's not like there is no lottery that you just invest money today and tomorrow you are double your money, you're rich. But if you keep your savings on the bank account the all of your life, actually the money are going to lose value because money is something that are subjected to devaluation. Things in the future will always cost more and money, more and more. And so the money that you give in the bank, they are just going to lose value, and that's why you need to invest. So I think that was it for this video. We hope we provide you with some good information. Of course, if you had some additional questions, leave that in down below in the comment section. And don't forget to give us a like, subscribe to the channel if it's the first time you see us, and if you have enjoyed the content.
Ciao.